Whether you want to believe it or not, before you are even born, significant aspects of your physical development are predetermined. The diet your father followed for years before fertilizing your mother's eggs, and similarly, the diet your mother followed for those years, in addition to her pregnancy, as well as nursing time spent breastfeeding. It seems as if our modern world is setting children up for disease and misfortune, starting with our parents. I won't touch too much on the health of the sperm and the egg, as well as the mother. It really encapsulates all of diet and lifestyle. And despite most mothers following poor diets, not containing the adequate nutrients for optimal development, babies are then bombarded with what seems like an attack on the human race. Not only do they not get the basics they need to enter the world, as soon as they enter the world, they are poisoned. The powers at be have convinced our parents to eat poison and disregard common sense. I'm sure they can convince them to use certain products for their newborn babies and children as well. Number one is baby formula. And I don't know how this stuff is even on the shelf, because if people read the ingredients, they should be rioting these companies out of business. Corn maltodextrin, vegetable oils, soybean, sunflower, enzymatically hydrolyzed soy protein isolate, sucrose, aka sugar, as well as over 40 synthetic vitamins and minerals. So a base of crap with crap added to make up for it. I mean, where do we even start? Every ingredient is loaded with agrochemicals, herbicides, pesticides, fungicides, insecticides, fluoride, chlorine, who knows how many other chemicals, antibiotics, metabolite residue, plus all of the laboratory chemicals that needed to go into each of those 40 plus synthetic vitamins and minerals. Humans' ability to survive, especially when being fed this crap straight out of the womb, never ceases to amaze me. Even if this formula was free of all of those chemicals, the base is still horrendous. It's cornstarch, omega-6 oils, and soy protein. How is that supposed to build a healthy body? I don't think you could feed a more poisonous concoction to a child if you wanted all of those ingredients to still count as food. I mean, you'd have to throw like gasoline and motor oil and bleach in there for it to be any worse. Even if the mother was on a poor diet and doesn't have the most nutritious breast milk, at least you're not poisoning your child and giving them severe organ damage, especially the brain and liver. And that is something overarching to just about everything I say. It's more important to remove the negatives as to overload the positives, but the positives do have to be present. Number two, we have baby food. And the main thing babies need for development is animal protein, animal fat, especially those omega-3s for brain development. The baby foods might not be as directly poisonous as the formula, but they still disgust me. The marketing of companies like Happy Baby Organics that are selling pureed kale and apples to babies under the guise of health is as evil as you can get. Happy Baby Organic, they're implying the food is healthy and it's going to make your baby happy. Hopefully, they puree some bugs in there to even out their karma. At least the babies will get some nutrition. Stuff like green beans, bananas, sweet potatoes, all typically pureed, are usually not organic, so there is an agrochemical concern. But even if they were organic, as pure as possible, are still not giving the baby what it needs to develop properly. You know, what happens if you feed a dog kale? It's going to starve to death. What happens if you feed a calf, a baby cow, grass? It's going to starve to death. Whoever is in charge of dictating childhood nutrition in the conventional space is doing an excellent job at making sure everyone's brain gets the bare minimum. Even so, many are less fortunate and don't even get to live a normal slave life. So if baby food wasn't already full of so much poison and devoid of nutrition, what can make it worse? Number three, iron fortification. They literally take iron shavings, iron filings, add them to cereal, grain, oatmeal, especially the baby formulas. I'm sure some of you bodybuilders are familiar with like cream of rice, cream of wheat, and you know, I would like to eat that stuff myself, but it's all fortified with literal iron filings. It's incredibly oxidizing, damaging to the body, and these poor babies' livers are literally getting filled with iron that they don't need and certainly aren't able to remove in those developmental stages of life. Even as an adult, I've consumed high-quality organic foods that were made with iron-fortified flour, and I felt like I was going to die for the rest of the day, my heart beating out of my chest. A lot of you guys are familiar with my problems with iron overload, and we do have a video titled The Iron Epidemic that you can check out. Number four applies to both food and environment. Water. The water used to grow, cook, and prepare the baby's food, as well as the water used to bathe them. Really, any water that interacts with the baby in any way, shape, or form. And most people know tap water is full of fluoride and chlorine, which damages our mind as well as our gut bacteria, let alone the thousands and thousands of chemicals and antibiotics, the residue they're not telling you about. Number five, we have Wi-Fi and EMF. And boy, do doctors love radiating pregnant women's bellies with ultrasounds.
Oh, but it's non-ionizing radiation.
Really? Your baby is getting radiated. Do you want your baby getting radiated? I don't think it matters what type of radiation it is. I've done videos explaining why non-ionizing radiation is dangerous, and these sonograms pale in comparison to the new devices in our modern environment emitting incredible amounts of radiation consistently all day, every day. Just a pregnant woman carrying a cell phone all day, microwaving her meals, being near routers, smart meters, let alone having a Wi-Fi baby monitor right next to the child. And if you do want to learn how to radiate your baby, check out Abby Sharp's YouTube channel. She does a real-time tutorial. Real dietitian expert. It's basic knowledge in countries like China that pregnant women need to wear garments and clothing that shield their stomach from radiation. Yet in America, it's the main unknown aspect in our lives, making our children and us very sick. Of course, we can't forget the injections, aka the V word for number six. I don't really want to go into specifics. You can just look up a list of the ingredients in these, and if you think it's okay to put that in your body, by all means, go for it. And if that's not enough, when you also find out that the elites don't inject their children with these, that should answer any concerns you had. The injections given to the newborn babies of the masses of the sheeple are filled with soft metals, chemicals, DNA-altering materials that damage the brain, body, and hamper development. You know, if your brain's trying to develop, but first it has to remove the aluminum from it, you know, it's not going to develop properly. If the elites were giving their babies something or injecting themselves, it's certainly absent of whatever is in our injections. And last but not least, number seven, we have hygiene, baby care products, diapers, baby wipes, powder, anything you would use in the context of a newborn child. And I'm sure the Amish are just using rags and water with their children, as we should now. The famous Johnson & Johnson baby powder lawsuit where people developed cancer is just a drop in the bucket of water for what's really going on. It's almost comical that letting a baby stay dirty is far healthier than the conventional cleaning wisdom available. Imagine your child goes out, rolls around in the dirt, they come inside, you rinse them off with fluoridated and chlorinated water, scrub them with this soap that's full of chemicals. Hey, now your child's clean because they're not full of dirt. Well, you know, our ancestors, even just dozens of years ago, let alone hundreds, were probably dirty most of the day, and they were far healthier than we are now. So thank you guys for joining me today. I think this is long overdue. I could have done individual videos on the baby formula, the baby foods. You know, we've talked about iron fortification, we've talked about water, we've talked about Wi-Fi. This little touchy subject right now, the care products too, but I think it's important to give a base of information, and if we really need to, we can go into specific details. Please sign up for the newsletter at frank-stefano.com to stay in touch. And guys, I spend like 25 minutes tracing this baby, so please, you know, drop a like on the video, leave me a comment down below. Make sure you click that notification bell so you know when my videos go live every day. But that'll be it. So thanks again for joining me, guys, and I'll see you for tomorrow's video.